More than 6 months have passed since the launch of Blue Origin's new Shepard rocket ended in failure. No humans were on board the vehicle, because it was conducting a sub-orbital scientific research mission. But the failure has grounded the new Shepard fleet ever since. Notably, on Wednesday, a company sales exec stated that the company expects to return its new Shepard rocket to flight by the end of 2023. But they will not release details of the failure investigation. This begs the question, what happened to Blue Origin? Let's discuss it today in this episode of Science of Space. We're sure you've heard about the new Shepard, the only Blue Origin active rocket at the heart of its space tourism and microgravity research business. Unfortunately, the rocket's single main engine failed, about 1 minute into the flight, at an altitude of around 9 kilometers. As it was throttling back up, after passing through the period of maximum dynamic pressure. At that point, a large fire erupted in the B3 engine, and the rocket was grounded for almost 6 months. The capsule experienced high G forces during this return but appeared to land safely. We hope to be back in the air with a new Shepard by the end of the year. Arian Cornell, Vice President of Commercial and International Sales, stated at a conference in Washington this week, that the company expected to complete a technical review of the new Shepard failure by December of last year. According to a Blue Origin executive, who told the Washington Post in November, but Cornell declined to provide details on where the investigation stands. Because we're working with the FAA, the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, which regulates commercial launch site safety, is overseeing Blue Origin's investigation, and must approve its findings. I can't go into specifics. When asked about the investigation's delays, Cornell stated, I'm not sure if we're going to release the details, it's something we have to coordinate with the FAA. However, in response to a Reuters inquiry, FAA spokesman Steve Com stated that, the FAA does not prohibit commercial space operators from publicly discussing information about ongoing mishap investigations. The FAA requested that companies coordinate the release of factual information in order to raise awareness and ensure that any mention of the FAA's oversight role in the investigation is properly portrayed. 3 days after the accident with the new Shepard, Com was restored. In an interview later that month, the chair of the subcommittee, U.S. Representative Don Beyer, a Democrat from Virginia, urged Blue Origin to be transparent. I'm a big fan of transparency, and I'm hoping that the FAA responds quickly to this buyer's request. I would strongly encourage Blue Origin to be as transparent as possible because it builds trust. It doesn't have to happen overnight, but it would be nice to keep people updated on their progress. Blue Origin, founded by Jeff Bezos more than 2 decades ago, has largely been non-transparent in its activities during its existence, only occasionally offering glimpses of its work through carefully choreographed public relations campaigns. Bezos almost never speaks with space journalists about the company's activities, and the new Shepard 23 investigation is no exception. Blue Origin has made no public statements about the failure. It is investigating or planning the next flight. The question is whether this will be an uncrewed or crewed aircraft. Blue Origin was flying two different new Shepard systems at the time of the accident. The RSS HG Wells capsule was flying science missions on Booster 3, and the newer RSS First Step was flying crewed missions on Booster 4. The company's oldest operational rocket, Booster 3, which launched the failed mission in September, made its debut on December 2, 2017. Blue Origin could choose to fly a rudimentary mission on Booster 4, and an uncrewed test flight on the rocket, or debut a new booster with modification. Made as a result of the lessons learned from the latest Shepard 23 accident investigation. The company has used its newest rocket Booster 4, exclusively for human launches. It has some modifications from Booster 3 to qualify as a human-rated rocket. According to Gary Live, the chief architect for the new Shepard at Blue Origin, who said that in February, Blue Origin would support about a few dedicated payload missions a year. The same as it has even as the number of private payload missions increases, dedicated payload flights will become less common in the future. These flights have carried more than 100 commercial payloads. While there is less space on the propulsion module for payload, the company's offering new research opportunities also include flying payloads on the new Shepard's propulsion module. Something, he said, can be done on both research and tourism flights. He also mentioned that there will be an option to allow payloads to be exposed for sampling the atmosphere or even deploy instruments. Another novel option is a low-gravity flight, in which the crew capsule is spun after deployment to simulate lunar gravity for a brief period of time. The company is also working with NASA to fly government researchers and astronauts through the agency's sub-orbital crew program. Blue Origin is looking at options for human-tended experiments, according to Lai, such as replacing seats with experiment racks. The company is also looking at updates to the new Shepard, though Lai said that changes would focus on operations and the customers likely. Do you want a high-priced seat on the new Shepard? I most emphatically do not, but I am considering SpaceX's Dragon. One of the most significant differences between the two spacecraft is that the SpaceX Dragon can fly in orbit, whereas the new Shepards are only designed for suborbital flight. The Dragon's ability to achieve orbit allows it to perform more complex missions, such as resupplying the ISS, conducting scientific experiments in space, and launching satellites into available orbit. Moreover, while the new Shepard is still attempting to conceal its failures, Dragons have sent 8 crews into orbit, and in a little more than 2 years. SpaceX has surpassed the total number of astronauts Notch launched into orbit by China, whose human space flight program dates back to 2003. And in the time the Crew Dragon's been operational, it has exceeded even the Russian Soyuz vehicles, in terms of the total number of people flown into space. During that period, SpaceX Dragon has safely returned the US's capability of human space flight, which had been lost since the space shuttle retirement, and Dragon not been available. So we are saving a ton of money on the high end, while we're still managing to utilize the commercial prices on the low end. The military hopes that by opening Lane 1, it will be able to nurture still more competitors for high-value missions later in the 2030s. And it appears that the newer US launch companies all have such aspirations. As we talk to the Rocket Labs, Relativities, the ABLs, they all talk about how they're expanding from their smaller launch focus into medium lift, Pentecost said. And everybody has plans to go even higher. Balancing range demand. One sign of the emergence of new competitors, as well as SpaceX and potentially United Launch Alliance ramping up their launch frequency, is the usage of the Eastern and Western ranges, operated by the U.S. Space Force. The Eastern Range encompasses Cape Canaveral and Kennedy Space Center, in Florida, as well as Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. The Western Range includes Vandenberg Space Force Base, and other U.S. launch sites in the Pacific. Pentecost shared the following data about increasing launch cadence at both ranges, as well as a projection for this year. One of the reasons why they selected SpaceX is because they placed the Europa Clipper in Category 3 for launch services. This means that the Europa Clippers should be carried on a commercial vehicle that has performed at least 3 successful launches. This put the Falcon Heavy miles above competing commercial rockets. You see, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy was successfully flown 3 times, despite not being launched since 2019. Other competing vehicles such as United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur and Blue Origin's New Glenn haven't even had their first launches.